Hi, I'm Ginny Yangling, and I'm a hydrogeologist at the Minnesota Department of Health. Today we're going to be talking about a category of chemicals called perfluoroalkyl substances, or PFAS. You may have also heard them called PFCs. In this video, we're going to be talking about why we're sampling for PFAS, what the sampling process is, where we find PFAS in southern Washington County, and how we decide which private wells to sample. To see this video again, or to find more information about PFAS, please visit the Minnesota Department of Health website. Based on the levels of PFAS that we are finding, there are no immediate health concerns, even if people are using water that exceeds our current guidance values. The PFAS that we find in Minnesota is typically well below levels that would pose concerns. Our goal is to lessen the long-term buildup over many years in the population of mothers-to-be. For more information about PFAS health risks, please go to the Minnesota Department of Health website. We understand people's concerns and their desire to have answers quickly. And that's why we have to focus our sampling in areas where the evidence shows it is most needed at this time. PFAS were manufactured in Minnesota. We know where they were disposed of in South Washington County, and we've been studying them since 2003. In light of new evidence, in 2017, the Minnesota Department of Health set new lower guidance values for two of the PFAS, known as PFOS and PFOA. Again, the levels of PFOS and PFOA that we find in most of southern Washington County are not at levels of concern for most people. These new lower values are set to protect our most sensitive groups. The state of Minnesota has been testing well water in Washington County to identify any drinking water wells that exceed these new lower health-based guidance values. We're targeting our investigation to find wells that exceed these new lower values. That's why we prioritize our sampling where the available evidence tells us it is most needed. We determine that based on our understanding of the geology and groundwater movement and almost 11,000 samples from over 2,700 wells in the area. The PFAS in Washington County are water soluble, which means they can move quickly through the water. As a result, they quickly left the disposal sites, entered the groundwater, and moved in the direction that the groundwater is flowing. This resulted in a large area of contamination that we refer to as a plume. This map shows the location of the PFAS plumes in Washington County. The blue arrows show the general direction or gradient of groundwater flow. South Washington County sits on a groundwater divide between two watersheds, and this controls the direction that groundwater flows. The approximate location of the groundwater divide is shown by this green dashed line. Groundwater on the west side of the divide flows south-southwest towards the Mississippi River, while water on the east side of the divide flows east-southeast towards the St. Croix River. Some of the PFAS also got into a surface water system in Oakdale and Lake Elmo, and this allowed them to be carried across the divide and into parts of West Lakeland Township and Northern Afton. PFBA is another type of PFAS. It's the most soluble, and so it doesn't stick very well to soil or to bedrock. And as a result, it's created the largest area of contamination shown here in brown. However, health studies suggest that PFBA has lower toxicity and does not accumulate in our bodies, so it has a much higher health-based guidance value than PFOS or PFOA. In fact, only a handful of wells very near the disposal sites have levels of PFBA that exceed its health-based guidance value. PFOA and PFOS are slightly less water soluble than PFBA, and to a certain degree, they will stick to soil and bedrock. And as a result, they've created somewhat smaller plumes that are shown here in green for PFOA and black hash marking for PFOS. You'll notice that those plumes are elongated in the direction of the groundwater flow. In some places, the plumes deviate from the groundwater flow, because they're following features in the bedrock, like faults or buried valleys, that channelize the flow of the water and the contaminants. The white and purple dots on the map show all the locations where we have sampled since 2003. The purple dots represent the over 880 private drinking water wells that exceeded our new lower health-based guidance values and where we have issued drinking water advisories. Some areas on the map don't have very many dots, and that's because those areas are served by city water. Or in the case of Afton and Denmark Township, it's because they're down gradient of areas where we have lots of sampling that show that concentrations of PFAS are not anywhere near our drinking water guidance values. Wells that come first for sampling are those that we've never sampled before, and that are located in or down gradient of areas where other wells have been issued drinking water advisories and have higher levels of PFOS or PFOA. That's why right now we're focusing our sampling in the areas of West Lakeland Township and northernmost Afton. We're also resampling wells that have levels of PFOS or PFOA just slightly below our guidance values. As we're able, we're also sampling wells in Cottage Grove and St. Paul Park, where concentrations of PFOA and to a lesser degree PFOS are more widely scattered and the concentrations tend to be lower than in West Lakeland Township and Afton. Once we've completed that sampling, we'll be able to sample additional wells in the lower risk area shown in brown. Well owners in the affected community can request to have their well sampled by filling out an online form on the Minnesota Department of Health website. Your well will then be placed on a list and will be sampled in the order of the priority I just described. We'll try to get it sampled as quickly as we can. You can find out more information about PFAS at both the Minnesota Department of Health and the Minnesota Pollution Control Agency's websites. You can also call the Department of Health at 651-201-4897.